Senator Parker.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good to see you, Commissioner. How's everything?
Good, Senator.
Good. I want to associate myself with the comments of Senator Wiesenberg, who I think you're right. People should know of his dedication, and certainly I share some of those concerns. So it's good to hear that community programs are going to be reflective of the commencement with the work that they're doing. What's exactly the cut that you've been instructed by from the governor to take for the agency, in both percentage and dollars, if you could?
To some extent, we don't know precisely what the end point is going to be, because, as I think there was testimony over here this morning, the administration is entering into conversations with labor, and the outcome of those conversations will partly affect what resources are available to us. But as I said, in terms of total dollars, I think the numbers that are printed in the budget reflect about a $23 million increase on the aid to locality side, and about a $95 million decrease on the state operations side.
So it sounds like it's a net loss.
A small net decrease, yes.
A small net decrease. And as you know, probably painfully aware, that Kingsborough Psychiatric Center is actually on the cusp of my district, but certainly in the bounds of the service area in which I represent. What does this cut mean for that agency, that particular facility?
Well, Senator, we've had many conversations about the status of that hospital, and I think it continues to improve, and I think it continues to face challenges at the same time. The one thing that I'll say is that there are multiple accountabilities, and these are legal accountabilities and they're moral accountabilities that require us to continue to meet external standards. So on the one hand, you can take my word for it with respect to quality, but on the other hand, you can look at reviews like reviews that are done by the Joint Commission, which is the same entity that accredits Columbia Presbyterian and Albany Medical Center. They say that our performance on those accreditation visits is better than the performance of medical centers in general across the United States. So Kingsborough, for example, successfully passed Joint Commission surveys within the last year. So the one thing that we're unequivocally committed to is maintaining that quality of care. There will be belt tightening, but we will maintain quality.
Okay. What does that mean? That mean that we, how many people are we firing?
I don't know the answer to that.
Okay. There's been we've had numbers of conversations about some of the problems there, and I know that you are committed to working on them, and I've been appreciative of your efforts. There's been recently an incident where it was alleged that a staff member was brutally beaten by a patient. Do we know where we are with in respect to that? And how are we addressing that in terms of making sure that something like that doesn't happen again, to both protect staff who work very hard for very little money, and also for patients who also in a conflict like that could also wind up being injured?
Thank you, Senator. The issue of safety for both patients and staff is one of the most important and one of the most challenging things that we have to work with. When you consider that everybody who is committed for care in a psychiatric hospital is committed against the legal standard of dangerousness to self or others, it makes you understand that maintaining safety is going to be very challenging. So you've got 25, sometimes 30 people on a unit. They all come with their problems and their issues, and we have to work exceptionally hard to try to maintain safety for the patients, for the staff, and also because we can't proceed to treatment and recovery if the situation isn't safe. But because of the challenges we face, violence in psychiatric hospitals always has been and is going to continue to be a real challenge. I know about the incident that you referred to. A nurse was badly injured. We are hearing some increased concern about this. It made me go back and look at the statistics and see that we had the less injuries to our staff last year, or in this year, in 2010, than we did in 2008. We had about the same number that we had in 2006. So I don't see an overall trend here. We actually report data publicly on patient injuries, and that data indicates that every one but two of our hospitals, I believe, 23 or maybe 23 out of 26 of our hospitals were below the national averages for patient injuries on data that's reported to the Joint Commission, and every single one of our hospitals was below the national averages for patients put in restraint. These are serious challenges all the time. I think in times like this, when there's stress about contracts, when there's uncertainty about the future, it makes people more nervous, which makes it harder in some ways to maintain quality. But the data show that the quality is being maintained as we're facing all these challenges.
So it sounds like to me that you're saying that because we're below the national average, and because there's some other stresses on employees, that in fact some of this, you know, may be more light than heat, and that there's nothing going to be done about improving the quality of safety for employees or for patients.
No, thank you, Senator. I wouldn't go that far.
Okay.
You know, nobody should be hurt.
Okay.
And anytime it happens, it's not right, and we have to try to provide good treatment for the injury and to try to prevent it from happening again. All of our staff are trained in how to try to manage these issues. If somebody is getting agitated, how to try to calm them down without having to resort to physical force. But as I say, because when every person sent to our care is sent as being dangerous to self or others, it does impose a challenge. So I can't say that I'm satisfied by this, but because we're concerned when people do get hurt, and we are committed to maintaining the quality, to not let the staffing slip below levels that are likely to make things more dangerous, and to just try to provide our people the support they need.
Okay. Let me just, and I'm done with my questions, but let me just say I appreciate your responses today. I would like to see an investigation to this particular incident and some kind of report so that I can respond to my constituents and to others who are concerned about this matter. But I also think that improved safety is something that we ought to be, you know, kind of the idea that eternal vigilance is the price of freedom, that we need to always be striving to be better about safety, and that we ought to be looking at this as not simply an isolated incident, or be satisfied with the fact that we're not above the national average as a way to, and I get that you're dealing with, you know, competing priorities, but I just think representing the people, both the nurse and the patient, that this is something that we need to address very seriously, and I would love to see a more assertive response to evaluating safety at that institution and making sure that something like this can't happen again. Thank you,
Commissioner. Thank you, Senator. We'll be in touch.
All right.